Defense Updates has reached more than 150,000 subscribers. We're genuinely thankful to our viewers. You keep us going. We don't dilute your video watching experience in this channel with sponsored products. If you like what we're doing, kindly support us at Patreon. www.patreon.com/defenseupdates. South and North Korea's capitals are just 120 miles apart, with Seoul within 35 miles of the border. Covering only about 12% of the country's area, the Seoul Capital Area is home to more than 48.2% of the national population and is the world's third largest urban area. Seoul is populated with 25 million people. Most of the North's artillery pieces, numbering in the thousands, are already in place, camouflaged, and dug in, some being very close to the border. Commonly referred to by the nicknames Warthog or Hog, the A10 was designed for close air support of friendly ground troops, attacking armored vehicles, artillery pieces, and providing quick action support against enemy ground forces. Hence, the Warthog is expected to play a major part if any conflict starts between the US and North Korea. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes if the A10 Warthog can counter the North Korean artillery.
Number 5.
The United States undoubtedly possesses the military hardware and capabilities to deliver an effective strike on Pyongyang's nuclear facilities. Retaliation by the North is highly likely to occur. While this could of course come in the shape of one of the regime's much vaunted intercontinental ballistic missiles armed with a nuclear warhead, observers believe the North's artillery would almost certainly inflict devastating damage against the South regardless of the missile program. While a substantial part of North Korea's military is made up of old, antiquated Soviet weaponry, its artillery capabilities remain exceptionally powerful. The North Korean People's Army Artillery Command has an estimated 12,000 pieces of tube artillery and another 2,300 multiple launch rocket systems. Koksan 100mm self-propelled guns and 240mm and 300mm multiple launch rocket batteries are capable of striking Seoul.
Number 4.
For North Korea, deciding exactly what to target with all those heavy guns would prove vital in any conflict. There are two realistic options, a counterforce attack or a countervalue attack. In a counterforce attack, North Korea would target South Korean and possibly even US military facilities near the Demilitarized Zone, DMZ, and north of Seoul. A countervalue attack, on the other hand, is intended to shock South Korea by causing significant civilian casualties and damage to economically critical infrastructure. Both the strategies would leave North Korean artillery vulnerable to counter barrages and airstrikes, giving the US and South Korea a chance at containing and eliminating the threat.
Number 3.
Placed into hard granite mountain faces and protected behind blast doors, artilleries can be hard to detect, even harder to neutralize. The constrained mountainous terrain on the Korean Peninsula and the heavily fortified nature of the Demilitarized Zone massively favor the use of artillery. Based on the few artillery skirmishes that have occurred, roughly 25% of North Korean shells and rockets fail to detonate on target. Even allowing for improvements and assuming a massive counterstrike artillery volley would be more successful, a failure rate as high as 15% would take a significant bite out of the actual explosive power on target. The rate of fire and accuracy of North Korean artillery systems is also expected to be subpar. This belief is founded on the observably poor performance of North Korean artillery crews during past skirmishes and exercises.
Number 2.
The A-10 Thunderbolt II is a single-seat, twin turbofan engine, straight-wing jet aircraft developed by Fairchild Republic for the United States Air Force, USAF. It was intended to improve on the performance of the A-1 Sky Raider and its lesser firepower. Its airframe was designed for durability with measures such as 1,200 pounds, 540 kilograms, of titanium armor to protect the cockpit and aircraft systems, enabling it to absorb a significant amount of damage and continue flying. Its short takeoff and landing capability permits operation from airstrips close to the front lines, and its simple design enables maintenance with minimal facilities. The A-10 served in the Gulf War, Operation Desert Storm, the American intervention against Iraq's invasion of Kuwait, where the A-10 distinguished itself. The A-10 also participated in other conflicts such as Operation Urgent Fury in Grenada, the Balkans, Afghanistan, Iraq, and against ISIL in the Middle East. The A-10 was designed around the 30mm GAU-8 Avenger rotary cannon. General Electric manufactures this hydraulically driven 7-barrel Gatling-type autocannon. The Avenger delivers very powerful rounds at a high rate of fire. The magazine can hold 1,174 rounds, although 1,150 is the typical loadout. Muzzle velocity when firing armor-piercing incendiary rounds is 1,013 meters per second. The GAU-8A is extremely accurate and can fire 4,200 rounds per minute without complications. The 30mm shell has twice the range, half the time to target, and three times the mass of projectiles fired by guns mounted in comparable close air support aircraft. There's no technical limitation on the duration the gun may be continuously fired, and a pilot could potentially expend the entire ammunition load in a single burst with no damage or ill effects to the weapon system itself. The aircraft can carry 16,000 pounds of mixed ordnance. 8 can fly under the wings and 3 under fuselage pylon station, Air Force statement said. The A-10 carries a full complement of weapons to include Joint Direct Attack Munitions, or JDAM, GPS-guided bombs. Its arsenal includes GBU-38s, GBU-31s, GBU-54s, Mark 82s, Mark 84s, AGM-65s, Maverick missiles, AIM-9 Sidewinder missiles, and rockets along with illumination flares, jammer pods, and other protective countermeasures.
Number 1.
Since the 1990s, right about the time the Clinton administration decided not to undertake military action against North Korea's nuclear program, the general consensus has been that Pyongyang had enough artillery to turn nearby Seoul into a sea of fire. U.S. has now better intelligence about the North Korean artillery sites, and they'll be one of the high-priority targets. After the initial barrage by F-22 Raptor, F-35 Lightning II fighter jets, and B-52, B-2 Spirit bomber, the Warthog will be able to take out the remaining with close-in bombing raids. The capability of North Korean artillery to keep firing will reduce with each hour as more of them get destroyed. But according to a new report by Stratfor, a geopolitical strategic forecasting firm, a single volley from the North Korean artillery could deliver more than 350 metric tons of explosives across the South Korean capital, roughly the same amount of ordnance dropped by 11 B-52 bombers. So the human casualty will still be very high if North Korea chooses a counter-value attack and targets the civilians.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.